Hello, so today we have another job. We have a desktop. It's an Dell Vostro. And it's a new generation. It's an i3, a 9 generation. And it's working very slow, very slow, and we have to make it work faster. We have an Windows 10 Pro version 2.1/1. It has 4 GB, and the reason it's working that slow is because it has a hard drive, not an SSD. As you can see, it has a hard drive with 1 TB hard drive, and while it will shut down because it's not going too fast. Let me show you. This is the service tag, and this is the model. Vostro 3471. Okay. And let's see what's inside. I just open the case. So here we have two screws. So it's with a fan in the upside. We have one screw here, one screw here. I'll pull this this lead to me. This is with backwards to me, and sorry, I can do it with one hand. Okay, you push it kind of one finger and up position, and here we have some dust, of course. It has an PCI Express X1 and one PCI Express X1.5. Huh. Awesome. Also, it has an M2. I think it's an M2 SATA, not an M2 NVMe, but I'll test it. And here we have the hard drive. You see? This is the hard drive. And it have only one SATA slot. Okay. Let's unplug the hard drive. This is power, and this is data cable, and we have one screw here and one screw here. Okay, and now let's see. I think first is to open this plastic, front plastic. Okay, so pry this four clips, and you can take off easily, and then hard drive Okay. We have here we have, you see, these clips, metal clips, and I push in that direction and this in to me. Okay, and now we have another two cable for DVD optical drive, and this is power for optical drive, and this is regular SATA data for hard drive. And we see here we have this is for SATA 2 is for optical, SATA 0 is for hard drive, and we have another SATA 3 here, but I don't know where to put another that drive. I'll check. Here we have a wireless, a modern wireless from a laptop version, and this is we have two antenna, 1 and 2. Okay, we have two wires. That's a nice one. I think this is DDR4 because it's E3 9 generation. Yes, DDR4 at 2666 megahertz. We leave it out because I want to clean the dust. And I want to check what SSD going here, SATA or NVMe, but I think it's SATA. Let's see what's right in here. No, here it's right M2A SATA 1, you see, but I think it's from here, SATA 0, SATA 2, SATA 3, so missing SATA 1, and that's SATA 1. We'll check. You have this plastic to put on shorter SSD, you see, from here to here, or standard longer one, 2280 till here. Okay, so let's check where we can put on standard SSD. Let's see. No, because here, if we can put it here, we block the air coming to interior of fans, and we have some other. No, we don't have. It's kind of it's space here, but I can see how to block in position. Of course, you can always put some puncture with hot glue, because an SSD it's very lightweight. Hot glue, okay. But I want to find where Dell thinking it has to put the third SSD. Let's see. HDD 3.5, 2.5. Ok, I have optical choose. So here we have a normal HDD 3.5. This is a 2.5 optional choose. Okay. And I think they are in the same position. Yeah. You see, here we have the screw from right side of the case of the computer. Okay. Okay. So you cannot put an hard drive, normal hard drive, and the tiny SSD in the same time. Let's see here. So take out this case. And let's see. So this is the normal position with an optical drive to the front and hard drive. Okay, hard drive is like that. So it slides in, it slide in here. So to take out, this is the normal position, slide to the left and in the up position. And the hard drive, it's holding by this two screw. And yeah, you cannot put an SSD here. They show loud, like you see. This is an optional case, because this is case a big case, and here it's a tiny case for two SSD. Okay, you see. But I think I can put an SSD in here. Maybe like this one, like this, and or like this, and put some hot glue in here. But if customer want, I can put an M2 SSD and don't have that problem with fiddling 2.5 inch SSD inside. So let's begin. First, I'll clean the dust because it's too much dust already. Clean the dust, change the thermal paste, and then check what SSD it support this this Dell. Okay, I'll be back. So first we clean the dust. To take out this plastic case from here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 holes with straight screwdriver. So you have to pry a little bit harder. Okay. Pry in the outside area and lift up. Okay. So this is it. Let's clean some more, and to clean best, let me take out the fan from the radiator. Okay, get out the wire, and this is it. You see? And in this, too much dust. Let me take another photo for customer. If you want to put on a hard drive and on SSD this type in here, you have another problem, because from a power source you have only, this is for optical and this is for hard drive. You have to solder another socket for getting power to SSD. That's why you have to let it out the hard drive and put at SSD, or let the hard drive inside and put an SSD here on M2. Okay. We wipe the dust with final step with isopropylic alcohol. and now we take out the radiator from CPU. Here we have another dust, of course, because dust enter in all area. Okay, this is perfect, but here we have dust and thermal paste. They have to clean very good. And be sure not to go into the main board and go into the pins of the CPU. Okay, I think it's good. When you clean the dust in here, make sure not to go into getting sure not to push the dust cleaner all the way to the pins, because they are very sensible. They broke and something to going wrong, it's very 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 easy to happen. Okay, so now we clean the CPU perfect, and now we put the CPU back. It has those holes to put in just one position. Okay. Thermal paste. We put an Arctic Mage 2, because that's enough. For the CPU. And now notebooks don't have exact position. You can put it in any position, because in here, in this position, this and this, or the third position, don't matter. And now we tighten them up a bit by a bit. Okay. Always do like this. A tiny in here, tiny here, tiny here, tiny here, all the way to the end. Because if you tighten up one screw from the first time to the end, that's a problem, because the radiator can will not stand perfect, and pressing too much in one side, and the thermal paste will not spread perfect, will going in one direction. And just 2-3 turn around, 2-3 here, 2-3 here, 2-3 here, and you're going in the circular way to the end. And that's it. Now we have the fan, and that's the tricky part, because I have to use a slim screwdriver. My regular screwdriver don't enter in through that hole, but it with the help of this scissors, it's kind of easy job. Okay. My phone announced me that file has a size limit error. No, I cannot. I need another screwdriver. I think this is perfect. Yeah, it's going perfect through this hole. Just remember not to press too hard in mainboard. I can do this outside, put the fan on the radiator outside the mainboard, but with some care you can put it here. So here we have a rear ward. Okay, so in the rear, and and. Okay. It has here two mounting hole, okay, going to this hole of the fan, and press, and that's it, perfect. This plastic is put here to suck air from outside the case, okay. Called cold air from outside of the case, because it without this plastic case is this space in here, and fan will suction air from inside the case, which is more warmer, okay. The contact area of the RAM, put it in here and leave it like this, and let's see. Keyboard and mouse, maybe it has a graphic BIOS, I don't know, we'll see now. Okay, fan starts spinning. Sorry, I have to take this call. So, let's see. I have not put yet an SSD, but okay, this. Too much light. power on. And F2, yeah, starting test, and going blank, fan still spinning, okay, F2, okay, prepare to enter setup. Okay, all good, now. I'll turn off the laptop, the computer, and put this SanDisk SSD. It's a SATA version, okay. And I put it in here, and I don't have a screw in this moment. I put this adhesive tape to the SSD to lower in slot. Power on. Okay. Now it's power on. F2. Let's see if our SSD is seen. Man, that this light today is very
very sunny.
Better, better. Okay, and yeah, we see. So this main board support SATA M2, okay, but let's test with an M2. I have a new M2. It's an Kingston A2000, and this is an NVMe SSD. And let's test with this one. This is a okay, and I put just for test that tape on top. Remember always always take out the main power source. Okay, I have here put it by me a switch, which is more easier than in and out the wire. So power on, and let's see. F2, and okay, so SATA none, you see. So this personal computer only sees SATA drive, not NVMe. Okay. So I put back the SATA drive, and let's put let me take out this this label from SSD. I put it in there only for my reference. Okay, now it's clean. And now, what a clever solution. You see, you put this plastic in here. And that's it. Awesome. Let's see. Let's test. Yeah. It stay enough. Yeah. It stays very nice in there. Okay. So leave it like this. Power on. Okay, now push the power button and press F2 on the keyboard. Okay, going in system information, and in here you see SATA 128 GB. Okay, job done. I call customer to ask him if I put another 4 GB of RAM, and talk to him. I'll be back. But That's it. I put back the. I have to clean this. I have some a little dust in here, and kind of that's it. So it's finally done. That light, it's killing me. I give it a restart now. And in the Windows, this is a SSD, as I said to you earlier, and it's working very nice. Working very nice, and I put SSD one partition and hard drive two partition, 350 gigabyte, and the rest of them, the space, and that's it. And off. Very fast. That's it. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye. I let it with 4 GB of RAM and without video card, because customer only use at bureau, not for not for games. Okay. That's it. Bye.